Today is the 66th Independence Day of India. And this morning when I got up, I said, I must make a video now and share with everyone how I got my freedom from overweight, excessive weight, and obesity. Freedom is basically what we want is freedom from fear, you know. Freedom means freedom from fear. And we want a country to be, to keep us safe. And so that's what freedom is all about. To be free from fear. Because when we don't have fear, we can peacefully think and do whatever we think is right. Otherwise, the fears don't allow us to. Yeah, and this problem, I mean, how to make India a great nation, a few years back, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, our president, after he gave up, after he finished his term in 2006-2007, he wrote this book, Family and the Nation. And
I would like to read a little bit of it.
He wrote it with Acharya Mahapragna and Abdul Kalam.
This book is about how to make the nation a great nation.
Nation means basically, he says, it's more the individual that's more important.
And
man's greatest battles, he says, have been waged against man-made obstacles and artificial handicaps thrust upon him to paralyze his growth and development. Human thought has always been bound in by tradition and custom, and education has always been perverted to suit the interests of those in power. This constant conflict has been a common feature through the history of mankind. So this made me start thinking, education has been perverted. Yes, of course, I knew it, but when it comes from Abdul Kalam was one of the greatest thinkers, of our time, and he said he was in charge of the space research program. He was the first person to put the satellite in India's first satellite into orbit, and then he worked for 8 years as a president, seeing the social problems and the political problems, everything. And coming from him, that education has always been perverted, made me start thinking, hey man, this is serious. And that's exactly what I found, you know. I mean, our education is catering to professionalism. It's not catering to make us happy. Professionalism, I mean, a profession is a paid occupation. And they want, I mean, it's all geared for that. And then the next problem he talks about, see, this book was nice in the sense that it raises issues which he wants us to tackle. Here on page, this was something like a bomb to me. Although I knew something of this sort was there. Crass commercialization has taken a toll on nutrition. The mass marketing efforts by food conglomerates, whose main interest is profit, compounded by misinformation by conventional healthcare institutions and their affiliates, make it difficult to differentiate between life-giving nutritious food and substandard devitalized food. And this is a heavy misinformation is being passed on to us by the healthcare institutions and their affiliates. Now this is a serious problem. And then he goes on to, what is it a surprise that many of our children, particularly in urban areas, are diagnosed with attention deficit disorders, ADDH, and other biochemical disturbances that are devastating their families and ultimately society? What are we doing to our children? Wow, I mean, I was not suffering from attention deficit, but I had, in college, I mean, when I was in IIT, the final year of IIT, I had started taking these attention-enhancing drugs. See, last year exam of mine was very, I was very stressed. The previous year my dad had expired, and the last year was, I mean, this is my, and I had to look after his old business, plus my studies. So, I mean, those I was heavily stressed, and I started taking those Dexedrine tablets for exams to study, keep me, remain awake till late at night and study. And I got addicted to those tablets. And so such a bad addiction that within a couple of months I was taking something like 150 tablets every day. I needed a whole strip of Mandrax tablets, 10 of them, just to go off to sleep, and that too only for 2-3 hours. And today, the same Dexedrine, that's dextroamphetamine, is being marketed as Adderall and given to children for attention deficits. So I mean, and of course, I became an addict the whole 20 years. I couldn't function properly in my addictions. Then after addiction, for the past 20 years, I've been helping drug addicts after giving. I have been the All India representative of Narcotics Anonymous, one of the, I mean, is the biggest worldwide fellowship helping drug addicts quit drugs and to make their lives manageable. So I was into that, and then the fourth year, I mean around 2006, I learned of amino acids therapy. There's something known as amino acid therapy, and that struck a chord in my head. I mean, because you see, I mean, around 1980, I was working on a farm. I mean, I had given up everything, so I just relaxed on the farm. I was growing mushrooms over there. And the neighboring farmers, they had decided to make poultry feed. And they were making, getting their own, what do you call it, groundnut cakes, soybean cakes, fish meal, and all those corn and all those things. They're trying to mix it together. According to the ISI, I mean the poultry ISI book, they were balancing the proteins, get the exact amount of proteins, get the exact amount of calories, add the things, but they were making a loss. And they asked me, Raji, why didn't you formulate the feed for us? And I found out that there is an ISI code for amino acids. And there are separate amino acid requirements for broilers, separate for layers. But I couldn't get those, the proper mix, because two or three of those amino acids were just not coming. I think it was tryptophan and methionine and maybe phenylalanine. These three amino acids, essential amino acids, I was not getting enough of them. But finally, I just told them to add a little bit of dried blood from the abattoir. If they were not abattoir, I got them a sack. And the moment they added that and got the exact amino acid requirement, wow, I mean, those poultry layers which were making a loss when started, their production shot up right up to 95, 98, whatever that peak efficiency was, and it remained over there. So that I had seen for myself, that amino acids are so important. So when I learned about the amino acids, I bought all the broke books. I mean, ordered, it took 2-3 months getting them from the USA. But I got the books and started looking into it. And I found out, yeah, if I take these, this is sort of addiction, this will cure my addiction. But whom am I going to test them on? I've given up drugs for 15 years. And testing it on these new, they would have, all the chaps in NA whom I was helping, addicts, they would have trusted me, but trying them on would be difficult on them, because I mean, I don't know whether it's really going to work or not. I've not seen it for myself. How do I test this on another person? So I decided to try it myself. Okay, I'll take it on the next one now.